I'm here at the Garden Grove Police Department to show them what a mentalist like me could do if given the chance to work in law enforcement. How can my abilities to hack into the human mind and read thoughts apply to police work?
Of all the positions here in the police department, the one I'm most fascinated by is the sketch artist. What they do every day is very similar to what I do. They decipher people's thoughts.
Forensic art can play a major role in nabbing criminals, but it's not an exact science. Eyewitnesses can be forgetful, and for good reason. When the brain experiences an extreme event, a memory is sealed in the unconscious so that the victim won't relive it. It's the brain's way of protecting us from stress. A sketch artist has to coax these memories out by any means. The best ones rely not only on the information, but also on the victim's emotional state.
Picking up on subtle, nonverbal clues during a victim's description. With that in mind, is it possible for me to implant the image of a person's face into an artist's mind using no words at all?
Let's go find out.
Thank you so much for taking the time to meet me here today.
Thank you for having me.
This is forensic artist Melissa Cooper. She doesn't know it yet, but I'm about to use my own psychological tactics to influence what she draws.
So tell me, how many faces would you say you've drawn at this stage?
Hundreds, if not maybe in the thousands. I've done so many.
And I guess when you're talking to a victim, some of the obvious things that you would ask a victim would be if the person is male or female, right? And then maybe the color of their hair and also the length of their hair.
Yes.
And then if they had some outstanding facial features. Tell me a little bit more about that.
I would ask what would make them more identifiable rather than another suspect in the lineup. So if there's anything specific, then that's what you want to hear.
Okay, well, I'm going to ask you to do a sketch right now, if that's okay.
Okay.
Now, obviously, not of me. Mm-hmm. And it shouldn't be anybody that you know or recognize. We'll do this just from your mind. Is that okay?
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, I'm going to close my eyes, though, while you do this. Okay. So I want you to take 20 or 30 minutes, and when you're finished, just let me know. Is that okay?
Okay.
All right, go ahead.
What Melissa doesn't know is that my friend Rob is sitting in the interview room next door. He's the person that I'm hoping she'll eventually draw. Although I've influenced her to draw Rob, she is completely unaware of this.
Done.
Great. Okay, so Melissa, my eyes have been closed the whole time you've been drawing, correct?
Correct.
So if I could tell you some details about that drawing right now, how would that make you feel?
Pretty surprised, I suppose.
Right now, Melissa really believes I'm reading her mind.
I think you've drawn a male, is that correct?
Yes, correct.
Caucasian?
Correct.
Dark hair, probably brown?
Yes.
Long hair, parted in the middle?
Yeah.
A goatee?
Yes.
Also a mustache?
Yes.
And finally, I'm thinking probably a mole on his face.
Yeah.
Can I have a look? Wow, I'm actually impressed because Melissa, believe it or not, this is a good friend of mine.
What?
I knew you wouldn't believe me until they introduced you to him. We've been in front of this door the whole time, Melissa, correct?
Yeah.
Melissa? Meet Rob.
Oh my God.
How you doing?
That is really creepy. Wow.
Pretty good match.
He started describing the features, even the most minute ones that I just drew. I don't know the secret.
How was Melissa able to know the person I was visualizing? Before we started the experiment, I subliminally triggered her using subtle visual clues.
If the person is male or female, right?
By giving a thumbs up with the same hand I gestured to represent male, I gave her the cue to draw a man. Stroking my chin subliminally told her I had a goatee in mind. Pointing at my face directed her to think of a mole or a freckle. I also gestured with my hands to indicate the length of his hair. Every action implanted a thought for her to pick up on subconsciously. Little did she know that she was sketching my friend Rob, who was sitting alone next door the whole time. Truth be told, sketch artists do this every day without even knowing it.